Good morning to everyone. I am Dr. P. Rajeshwari, Assistant Professor of Commerce, ADM College for Women, Nagapattinam. Now we see financial management and its objectives. Finance is the lifeblood of every business. Circulation of blood is necessary for maintaining life in human body. In the same way, finance is absolutely necessary for the survival and smooth running of a business. Let us see what is financial management. Financial management is a management function which is concerned with the management of funds. It is an administrative area or set of administrative function which refers to the management of function, both its sources and its uses. It includes management of funds and making decision with finance. The financial manager to plan for financial planning and raising of financial resources, management of the financial resources and control of financial resources. Now we see objectives of financial management. There are two objectives. Main objectives is profit maximization and wealth maximization. What is profit maximization? The basic objectives of business enterprises is profit maximization. Financial management aim to safeguard the economic condition of person who are directly or indirectly concerned with company. They must get the maximum return for their contribution. This is possible only when the company earn higher profit, and it includes natural goal, measures of efficiency, internal generation of fund, protections against risk, fulfillment of social obligation. So profit is main aim of the every business. Now see wealth maximization. Another main objectives of business enterprises is to maximize the value of the company in the long run. It refers to the wealth of stockholders in the long run. It also it involves of net present value of an investment. What is net present value? Net present value difference between present value of inflow and outflow. The main objectives of wealth maximization is fair return to shareholders, adequate growth and expansion, efficient and effective utilization of finance. Next, we see functions of financial management. Functions of financial manager can be divided into two functions, executive functions and routine function. In executive function, first we see financial forecasting. The prime responsibility of financial management is to see that an adequate supply of cash in hand at the proper time for smooth flow of the firm activities. Since both cash inflow and cash outflow are closely related to the volume of sales, it requires financial forecasting. Thus, the estimation of the inflow and outflow of cash in the next is necessary to maintain the liquidity of the funds. Then second executive function is investment decision. The investment decision is the most important aspects of executive functions of a financial manager. In investment decision, the allocation of capital to various investment proposal is made in order of their probability. Each investment decision necessary involves a risk and a financial help in evaluating the various proposal under with the process of capital budgeting. Then third executive function is management policy. The formulation of sound asset management policy is a successful of financial management. The fixed and current asset of the firm must be managed efficiently to ensure success. The financial manager is charged with verifying degrees of operating responsibility over existing assets. He is more concerned with the management of current asset than with the fixed asset. The next, management of income. It includes allocation of net earnings among shareholders. The finance manager try to get an optimal dividend payout ratio that maximize shareholders' worth in the long run. The next, assessment of attitude. It is the capital market as an attitude towards the company and its shares. So the financial manager to assessing the capital market attitude. Then decision about the new source of finance. A business firm is always in need of funds. So the financial manager, on the basis of forecast of the volume of operation, should decide upon the needs and prepare the detailed financial plan for the procurement of funds, both short term and long term. It is the responsibility of the financial manager to evaluate the cost of funds as against the anticipated profit from the use of these funds. The next, analysis and appraisal of financial performance. To carry out finance functions smoothly, Proper analysis like checking and appraisal of financial performance are very essential. For this purpose, various financial statements are prepared, analyzed, and the necessary guidelines are set up for future guidance. Then last, the executive function is advising to the top management. It is an expert duty of the financial manager to advise the top management in respect of financial matters, to suggest various alternative solutions for any financial difficult, and to make steady effort to increase the probability of capital investment in the firm. Next, let us see financial decision. In financial decision, the three decisions are very important. First one is investment decision, and financing decision, and dividend decisions. Finance function in the modern way using economic finance may be defined as the provision of money at the time it is wanted. Finance may be broadly defined as the activity concerned with planning, raising, controlling, and administration of funds used in the business. What are the types of finance functions? First one is investment decision. It is concerned with the effective utilization of funds in one activity or the other. This comprises decision relating to investments in both capital and current asset. The financial manager has to evaluate different capital investment proposal and select the best keeping in view and overall objectives of the enterprise. The investment decisions are of two types. First one is long-term investment decision and second one short-term investment decision. In long-term investment decisions refer to the capital expenditure decision. In short-term, it concerned with the management of working capital. The second type of finance decision is financing decision. It is the most important decision of the management. The finance manager has to decide the source of finance for financing the investment. Debt and equity are the two major sources of the long-term finance. Use of debt helps to enhance the earnings of the shareholders, but excessive debt increases the risk. Hence, before using any particular source of capital to the relative cost of capital, degree of risk control, etc., has to be carefully examined by the finance manager. The third decision is dividend decision. Dividend decision helps the management in the declaration and payment of dividend to the shareholders. It decides how much the earnings should be distributed among the shareholders and how much should be earned in the business for future expansion. The next, we have the functions of finance management. There are four functions of finance management. First one is procurement of funds, efficient utilization of funds, increasing profitability, and maximizing firm wealth. Now we see what is procurement of funds. The main aim of the finance function is the provision of adequate finance to meet the requirement of the finance. Finance must be provided in time at the reasonable cost. So the funds is mostly used in the business for an effective utilization. And then effective utilization of funds is the fundamental requirement for the success of the finance function. The firm must generate a higher return than the cost of funds. So has to the earnings of the shareholders. The third function is increasing profitability. Finance function should earmark increasing the profit of the business. All financial decision includes the profits. Hence, decision making should always be guided by probability criteria. Increasing in probability can be achieved by low cost funds, efficient management of long terms, and working capital by selection of investment, etc. And then last function is maximization firm value. Finance function play a key role in the maximization the firm value. To considerable extent, the value of the firm depends on its profitability. Besides sound decision making with the regard to capital structure, dividend, bonus shares, etc., helps in maximizing the profit. Market value of shares is maximization value of the firm. Then last we see organization of the finance function. Survival and success of the firms depends upon the finance function. In every organization, the finance function will be differ according to the concern. The board of directors can be managed by the managing director. The managing director will control the control, production manager, human resource manager, finance manager, and marketing manager. The main role of finance manager, they have to be control, treasurer, and controller. Then, the functions of treasurer. provisions of finance, investor relations, insurance, receivable management, cash management, investments, and functions of controller, planning and control, reporting and interpreting tax, reporting and government, protection of assets, economic appraisal. The main aim of the financial manager has to associate with the formulation of policy and making decision of the firm. Financial planning and controlling is the main advisory role of the finance manager. What is treasurer? Treasurer has to manage the funds, and controller has to management and control of assets. The functions of treasurer. The first function of treasurer is provision of finance. Provide adequate and timely finance, and they have to be forecast the short term and long term financial terms. The next, investor relation. Creating and maintaining market value of the securities of the firm, and have to maintaining cordial relationship with the investors. And they have to be efficient receipt to investors, that is shareholders, dependent holders, etc. Then receivable management, granting of credit and collections of dues from debtors in timely. It is very important for the financial manager, that is under the control of treasurer. Then what is cash management? Maintaining optimum cash balance to maintain the payment. Then investments relating to monitoring and realization of the investments. The last one is insurance. Arrangement adequate insurance coverage whenever required in the business. Then functions of controller. Planning and control. It is the first function of controller. So control, they have to be manage and control of funds. Planning and administration of control programs such as budgeting, reporting system, profit planning, etc. Reporting and interpreting, sound financial report system to meet the financial requirements. Tax administration, payment of tax returns and tax planning. Then fourth one is reporting to government, providing information required by the government on various financial matters. Then protection of assets, decision and implementation appropriate system like internal control and internal audit for the protection of the firm asset. The last one is economic appraisal, advice to the management recording the outlook of the economic effect of economic and social force on the business. Thank you.